From deep beneath the surface of the Columbia River, the river pump house's 10 mighty pumps moved water to the nearby reservoir. 500 feet square, this concrete reservoir could hold 25 million gallons of water, enough to fill 18 Olympic-sized pools. Next stop was the filter plant. For even though the Columbia was remarkably clean, water used to cool the reactor had to be absolutely pure, containing no more impurities than 2 parts per billion. At the chemical pump house and water lab, water was treated to minimize corrosion and any buildups inside the reactor. At the deaeration facility, water cascaded down huge columns to remove gases, especially carbon dioxide and oxygen. The process pump house held 10 massive pumps that used both electric and steam power to move the treated water first to the pipe gallery, then through the reactor, onto the retention basin, and finally back to the river. 2 elevated storage tanks held enough water to cool the reactor for 2 hours in an emergency, enough time to bring in water from other sources. A large capacity export water line provided a direct source of untreated water that would also serve to cool the reactor in an emergency. The B Reactor building was the heart of the project. The elaborate pipe system inside kept the reactor cool, while its 200-foot ventilation stack dispersed air from inside the building. A few particles would inevitably become radioactive as water passed through the reactor. So the water spent 3 to 4 hours in a retention basin, allowing time for radioactive elements to decay. Then the water rejoined the Columbia, its mission successfully accomplished.